So I'm gonna wait a few minutes so everyone can join. So today we're gonna go back to painting. We're gonna paint an easy landscape. So for today's class, we need a brush, paper towel. Sorry, brush, paper towel, water, and our colors. So I don't have a specific reference picture, but we're gonna have like two different pictures so we can combine them both. So I'm gonna show you now. So the first thing we're going to paint is the the sky. So sorry, let me just bring it up here. So we're gonna paint Calgary's skyline. So the sky will be something like this. And then for the city itself, we'll paint Calgary. And I have this reference picture. So we have the tower, the bridge, the bow. So we'll just combine those two pictures. And this will be just in black, and the sky will have blues, purples, and lighter purple / pink. So if you want, you can get started. I'll let you take a picture of the skyline.
大家就拍照啊,拍照呢,我們今天畫這個天,那個天就在這裡了。下面那個不同的,下面那個是另外一幅。
Let's start with the sky. So to do the sky, remember we have to be fast so the paint doesn't dry on our canvas and we can blend it. So we're gonna have the palette. So we're gonna have our three colors in the palette. Make sure you have enough. And then we're gonna put them all basically at the same time on the paper. So the colors we're gonna use today are blue. If you have dark blue or this brilliant or ultramarine blue, it's a little bit darker for the top. And then to get to the purple, we're gonna use the same blue, but just add red. Sorry, my puppy is crying in the background. And white for now. And also black, but we'll use that later. So we're gonna use these colors. If you happen to have a purple like this, you can also have it nearby. So the first thing the first color I'm going to mix is purple. So purple you get by mixing red and blue. Make sure you have enough to cover a third or the area you want to cover. So I'm gonna mix my, so I have my page. I'll divide it in two thirds. The top will be blue, the middle will be purple, the bottom will be light purple slash white. So let's mix our, so I have blue and I grab red, I mix them together. And I get a very dark purple. I'm gonna test it over here on the tape. Very dark purple. So I'm gonna add white. Whenever you're adding another color, make sure you just do it in small sections or just add just a tiny bit first because some colors are strong. If your purple looks too blue, then add more red. So if you're happy with your purple and your blue, don't take too long before you start painting. You can grab a big flat brush so it's easier. So I'm gonna start with my blue sky at the top. And then I keep going with my purple. I go back and forth to mix it. you see the importance of doing it quickly, because I want my blue at the top to mix with my new color. So the next is, I keep going with my purple, and as going farther down, I'm just adding a tiny bit of white. So I just have the purple I mix, and I just add white. And I can even just add white directly at the bottom of the page. So if you run out of your color, remember red, blue, and white to mix your purple. Now I'm adding a lot of white. I'm just gonna mix a little bit more. Just run out of my colors. I still have a little bit of purple here in this brush. And I'm just going to add white at the bottom. I just have pure white, but because my brush still has some of the purple left, it'll mix nicely. It's easier if you mix enough paint at the beginning so you don't have to try to mix again the same color. Because every time it could look a tiny bit different. So I'm mixing again, blue, red, and white, to get a dark purple for the top. I just test over here. So this dark blue, dark purple-ish blue. I think I'm happy with my sky. And we're gonna let it dry. Once you're done, make sure you clean your brush. And if you're done with your sky, what we're gonna do next is the stars on the sky. So we will need a dry brush and white, just pure white. Actually, just get the bottom just a little bit lighter so there's more contrast when we paint the building. So I'm just adding pure white here at the bottom with a tiny bit of water. Just white, and I have water on my brush. I'm just making it lighter. Maybe yours is already lighter. This is the same purple. Perfect. I'm going to clean my brush. And I'm going to wait about a minute or so you finish your sky. And then for the next step, we're going to use pure white and a dry brush. So for the next step, we're gonna grab a dry brush and another brush that you're not gonna use. So we just want this part. So what I will do is I'll have my dry brush grab white. And kind of do this so you get little particles of paint on your brush, on your canvas, I mean, sorry. And we're gonna repeat the process. Try not to grab too much paint initially. So we're starting to get stars. Just a few here and there. And then once you're done with your paper towel, just clean the brush you used. And now we're going to grab a round brush. Small round brush that you can put little dots. So this, just like that, so we know we're doing bigger stars. Maybe we can draw the moon over here. I know it's hard to see on the camera, but I'm sure you're seeing your tiny, tiny particles of paint in your canvas. And we're gonna let that dry. Okay, so while that dries, we can let you take a picture of Calgary's skyline. If you live in another city and maybe you want to do that other city, let me know. I can look for the image. So just 1 second. So we're going to draw just with pure black paint. And it depends on how you want to do your painting, but let me show you here. So I want to do the skyline just along this bottom here. But if you want to make it taller, that's okay. You can do that too. It may not fit the whole thing, but you can definitely do that. So if you want, you can do it with a pencil first. So you can draw the buildings and then just paint it over if you feel more comfortable doing it that way. So if you do want to draw it with the pencil, that's okay. Just make sure you don't draw too much so the colors don't get muddy, but you don't have to watch all the buildings either. So I think I'm gonna do the tower over here. We can start with the tower and go from there. This is just more like lines. So that's my tower. The bowl is a little bit taller. So it's like this. Then there's this. The bowl. Then there's this building right here. And there's a tall building over here. One over here. I'm just going to move my tower a little bit more to the left. Bridge. Actually, the bridge should be just a tiny bit lower. And then there's my tower over here. Do your pencil marks don't have to be perfect? Don't even have to go all the way to the bottom. This is just a rough guideline that will be covered with paint. So the bow, there's another building with the pointy. Okay, so that's a rough guideline. And now I'm gonna get started with the paint. So I'm gonna use the small black brush, and we're gonna use a lot of black. So just pure black. I'm gonna start with a horizontal line at the bottom. Start with this building over here. Make sure you follow the shapes of the building. They're not all just a rectangle. And what I think will be easier is if you paint like the block, if there's little detail that we need to add, we can just add it later with a smaller brush. I skipped these two buildings, so it would fit, but you, if you drew them, that's fine too if it fit. I'm leaving some things blank just because I need to grab a smaller brush. Now I'm going to switch to a more pointy, small brush. For the bow, I'm just going to grab a very, very pointy brush. I only have this big one. So if you notice, they're like triangles. So I'm just going to draw that. Ideally, I leave the space blank in between them. So let's try this. So upside down, and then you see how I do two triangles, one upside down, the other one just a regular triangle looking up. That gives me the space in between. You can just paint the whole thing black and go over with white for the background color and paint the lines, but I want to show the transition of the sky. I'm just going to do this instead. The key is to have a very pointy brush. You see how big my brush is? But I'm just using the paint on the very end of the tip. Just gonna zoom in so you can see. Just doing this. Sorry, I need to move the camera. And we're almost done. Make sure you clean your brushes. And I'm just gonna sign it with a pen this time. Just over here. Sorry, Dan. And that is our painting. So now I'm gonna remove the tape at the bottom. Just gonna cover that bottom painting. Just 1 second. Just gonna put a little bit of tape. Make sure you sign and date it. So if you're all done, you can show us your finished painting.